Moe thought he was going to be on the inside with the celebrity. Big old fan, and now you're not sure you want to be on the inside.
Yes, sir. I am in a bit of a dilemma that involves racism. So I'm not exactly sure how to handle it. And I got one way that I think I should, but my friends think I should handle it a different way. So basically, I'm a huge boxing fan. Always have been my entire life. And Tyson Fury, who is the current heavyweight champion of the world, had a fight a couple weeks ago against a guy named Deontay Wilder. And he won. It's a big trilogy fight. Pretty big deal. So like heavyweight fighter in boxing, if you don't know, is pretty much the highest honor that you can hold in the sport. It's a big deal. And so I was out of town when this fight happened. So it was me, my old man, and a good friend of mine who lives in that state. And so we were just trying to find a place to go watch this fight. And so I find this place, like a random place. They're having it, and we go. And it turns into this, like, crazy night. Because when we first got there, we pulled up, and it was sketch. Like, we wasn't sure. It was one of those spots where you look at and you're like, okay, we might not be in the best neighborhoods. And my father, I could see him feeling, like, hesitant. He's like, yo, man, I think we should go somewhere else. And I'm like, yo, the fight starts in, like, an hour. Like, we don't have enough time. Like, let's just go.
And if your dad's, like, spidey sense is going off, he's a cop.
Yeah.
Like, so you pay attention to that.
100%. Right? So I'm thinking, like, what should we do? And then I'm like, nah, we're going to have to get a whole nother lift, and it's a whole nother thing. I'm like, we'll be fine, right? So when we go into this place, it was a white guy standing outside, like, by himself, and he's dressed to the nines. Like, he just looks like money. He's dripping. He looks good. He's killing it. And it was just funny because he had some swag to him, and when we walked up, he was like, hey, guys, you know, I thought the same thing. It's cool in here. Don't worry about it. And I'm like, okay.
This,
like,
guy that works there or a guy that's...
I don't know at this point. He's just standing out there by himself in this sketchy neighborhood telling me that we good in there.
If he works there, he's going to tell. Five stars. Everything's great inside. Yeah.
He's not going to say, if I were you guys, I would not go in there.
Yeah.
I was assuming by the way he was dressed, though, he definitely didn't work there. So we go in. And it looks a little different on the inside than it did on the out. Like, the inside was nice. The outside, it was just in a bad neighborhood, but the inside was nice. So we walk in, and now I'm even more impressed that this dude has so much swag and was so confident, because it's nothing but black people in here. Okay. Like, his table, only white people in the room. So now I respect him even more. So we get a table, and we happen to sit right behind him. So when he walks in, he starts talking to me, and we strike up a conversation. And he's like, who you here, you know, who you rooting for? So I'm like, I'm rooting for Tyson Fury. And I could tell that kind of took him aback, because in this fight, pretty much, like, the black people are going for the black guy, the white people are going for the white guy. It's like that kind of thing.
Okay, so I don't follow boxing that much anymore. So who's the black guy and who's the white guy?
Deontay Wilder is the black guy. Tyson Fury is the white guy.
Okay.
So me being the black guy going for Tyson Fury, like, all of my friends are kind of clowning. Like, you're not going. And I'm like, listen, I'm going for the winner, bro. I don't care about none of that. I got my money on a guy I think is going to win.
All you see is green.
That's
all
I see.
White.
I don't care about none of that, right? So he respected that. And we're, like, kind of laughing, because he's like, well, that's a good thing, because all of my guys are fighters and Tyson Fury is my cousin. So I'm like, oh, come on, man. All right, so Deontay Wilder's my cousin, too, if that's what we're doing. You know, like, this is what we're doing. He's like, nah, man, I'm serious. And, you know, Tyson Fury is British. So he has, like, they all have the same accent. I'm like, maybe it could be true, maybe it cannot. Then he's like, you know what? Since I can tell you don't believe me, I'm going to FaceTime him right now. Now, mind you, this dude is about to fight in a heavyweight championship fight. I'm like, there's no way this dude answers this guy's FaceTime. It's not going to happen. This dude answers his FaceTime.
Shut up.
I promise you, Tyson Fury is on the phone, and he's, like, sitting on a couch in shorts, like, chilling. Like the biggest fight of his life is about to happen in 30 minutes, and he's chilling.
30 minutes away.
30 minutes away. He actually answered the phone.
Okay.
And I see Deontay Wilder, like, because they're showing him on the screen. He's, like, sweating. He looks nervous. He's fighting. I'm like, yeah, put everything on Tyson Fury. This dude is so relaxed. He's chilling. He answers the phone, and he's, like, kind of, like joking with him. Like, what do you want, man? You know I'm about to fight. He's like, hey, man, this guy didn't believe you were my cousin, so just say hello. So he's like, he gives me, like, the peace sign. He's like, what's up, man? And I'm like, okay, this dude really is Tyson Fury's cousin. So now, obviously, the night becomes entertaining. And so eventually, I find out that I don't know what these dudes genuinely do for a living. I just know they got a lot of money. Like, they're all pulling up in Ferraris. They're having arguments about whose car is faster, my Ferrari, his Ford F39718, whatever it was. And this is, like, the kind of thing that they're into. So as the night progresses, I end up exchanging numbers with this guy. And I was thinking to myself, I'll get an opportunity to talk to them later about whatever, because we just hit it off. We just had a good night. So the night ends in tragedy, because I don't know what happened, but I looked up and one of these guys are now going at it with one of the security guards. So the security guard goes to, like, grab his shirt and pull him out of the venue. And I don't know what started that fight, but all of these guys at this table got up. And they all went over there to figure out what was going on. Next thing I know, security comes from everywhere, and it's like a whole fight in the place. And so I didn't get to, like, talk to them or anything. I didn't get to, like, it was no closure. I just ended up watching the fight. They ended up getting kicked out, which sucked because I really wanted to watch them watch, you know, the fight with them because that's his family.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking to myself, I'll probably never hear from them again, whatever. It was a great night. It's a great story to tell. That's the end of it. Well, he ends up texting me. Hey, mate, sorry that I didn't get to have a good night with you. Let's hang out again. You know, where do you stay? And, like, let's get together, discuss business. Let's do whatever. So I'm like, yo, I was hoping I would hear from you. I got excited. So then he's like, I know you're a fan, so why not come hang out with me and my cousin and let's talk. So I'm like, this dude is going to have me come kick it with the heavyweight champ of the world. That's fire. Like, what? That's amazing. And as life would have it, I am sitting there on Twitter one day, like after I get this invite, this is like right after Tyson wins his fight, and he's like in his home, and it's some, like, I don't know who's recording him, but somebody's recording him, and he looks into the camera, and he's singing the Biggie song. And if you don't know, now you know. And he says the N-word, just drops it like so comfortably, like it was nothing to him. And I saw it on Twitter. A few people said something, but for some reason, it didn't take off like that. Like, people didn't really make a big deal of it. But as soon as I saw it, like, it changed everything I felt about this man, because his entire, like, being throughout this entire fight has always been, this is not about race. This is two men getting in the ring, warriors we're fighting. Because Deontay Wilder did try to make it about race at one point, like, this is black versus white. And he was like, no, it's not. It's two men getting in the ring. Mm-hmm. Don't even bring that over here. And I respected that about him. And then when I saw this video, it just changed everything instantly.
So is this ignorance that you're fighting with, or is this racism that you're fighting with, or does it even matter?
I just feel weird now. I feel weird even wanting to be around him. I don't have the same type of feeling. It sucks because I'm like, damn, I've always rooted for this dude. I've been a fan of this dude. I'm about to be in a room with him. And one of my guys is like, yo, this is not a, you don't walk away from this. Like, still go meet him. Go kick it with him. And when it comes up, talk to him about it. So I'm like, you want me to tell the heavyweight champion of the world that I don't agree with something he did and just let that go however that's going to go? Like,
yeah.
That's...
Do it. And then you get punched in the face. That's bragging rights.
And you sue him.
Yeah, he ain't going to hit me. Because if he hit me, we pay.
I mean, if you're calling him out for what he did and he hits you, that's a hate crime.
No, nah, for sure. I just don't think he'll be that stupid to hit me knowing who he is. But no. I really do don't. I don't. I'm just torn, man. Because I'm like... It doesn't even have the same feel to it to go meet him now because of how comfortable. And I know it happens, but when you know somebody's filming you and you still say it and you're so comfortable saying it, I was like, I don't know if I want to be in the same room with this dude anymore.
I wish I could share, like, that's your experience, like, that word and what it means to you. Only you know. So if you're uneasy about hanging out with a dude that signifies to you that's probably a racist, I don't see how, knowing you, how you could be comfortable going.
Yeah, I can't. I don't think I can get around it. And it doesn't necessarily mean he's racist, but it does mean to some extent he doesn't respect what black people stand for, especially if you are willing to look into the video, knowing you're being recorded, knowing who you are, knowing this is going to go viral, you do it anyway. It just felt wrong. It felt like I would almost be a fraud to go be around this dude and kick it with him now.
But he's a celebrity!
Ew!
No, you're right.
The Bert Show.